Did you put a lot of effort into organizing your sockets only for it to fail when you need it the most? Are you constantly digging through your socket drawer looking for the right socket but you can never find it? How frustrating! Have you been so fed up looking for a socket that you just give up and go buy another set? Don't be that person. Organize your sockets quickly and efficiently. If you have tools, I'm sure that you have socket sets. One of the difficult things about sockets is keeping them organized in a uniform fashion. As you buy new sockets, hex bits, Torx bits, then it begins, you start throwing them in your toolbox and they're not very organized. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna review 7 different methods that I have found to organize your sockets, and then I'm also gonna show you what I found to be most effective for me. There are plastic trays with magnets at the bottom that you can use to hold your sockets. This is for a 1/4-inch drive, and you just put your shallow sockets here and your deep well sockets there. One of the things I don't like about that is that if you have a socket that doesn't fit in the provided slot, then you don't have any way to put that in your organized method. So then you got to take this socket and put it somewhere else, and then you end up looking for this one socket and you can't find it in your tray. They make them for 1/4-inch, 3/8, and 1/2-inch drives. Typically these are about $15 to about $22, $25 depending on where you buy them. So it can get pretty expensive if you try and use this method to organize all of your sockets. I also don't like that it lays all of your sockets out flat and it takes up a lot of room. I'd rather have them standing upright. Now there are some plastic trays with magnets at the base that hold your sockets upright. What I don't like about it is that it spaces every socket out the same. So if you have a really small socket like this, it's going to have the same spacing as a big socket like that. And so what it does is it spreads out all of your sockets when in reality you could scrunch all of your 1/4-inch drive sockets in a small space and only your 1/2-inch drive sockets need all of that space. You can get those trays for sockets for just one row, or they have multiple row trays. Typically they're about $11 to $23 depending on the configuration. There are some plastic trays that don't have magnets on them, but instead have a rod that sticks up through the socket and has a beveled edge on it that you can read the size of the socket. One of the things that I don't like about it is that it provides all of the socket sizes, but not all socket sets have those sizes, and some have sizes that aren't listed. For instance, my metric socket set has a 7.5 millimeter. Well, if I bought this tray, I wouldn't have a place to put that socket. Where would I put it? Or some of my socket sets don't have, say for instance, a 16 millimeter socket. So that rod would just be empty. And so I'd be kind of wasting some space. Those trays run about $11 a piece. Harbor Freight does have some that kind of mimic it, and those run a 3-pack for $10. I've seen some videos and markups on socket organizing that uses foam. What they do is they'll cut out rectangular spaces for them to lay their sockets horizontally. But again, that takes up a lot of space. And another thing that people don't think about is that if you ever want to move your sockets from one side of your drawer to another, you've already committed by cutting that hole in that foam. You can't easily change it. The foam can be relatively inexpensive if you get some from Hobby Lobby, or you can opt for the more expensive 3-layer foam. Another method that I'm sure everyone is aware of is a socket rail. These socket rails can be purchased from Harbor Freight for about 99 cents, but you can get some more expensive plastic ones. There's some that twist on as you put the socket on. But these 1/4-inch drive sockets, they're really tough to get on and off. And if you aren't careful, then all of your sockets can fall off when you pick it up. They're also kind of flimsy. Some people try and combat that by putting it on a piece of wood like this. But it's still tough to get those sockets off. I just don't like the socket rails. At one point, I had all of my sockets on socket rails, but then after using them, all of the sockets came loose from the socket rails, and it just was a mess. I saw a method where someone had taken some drill bits and they bored holes in a piece of plywood, and then they put all of their sockets in those holes. You could also use the same idea using a router and just cut slots in a piece of plywood. What I don't like about it is that once you've cut the hole in the plywood, you're committed to that configuration and those sockets. If you were to get another set of sockets and you wanted to replace one, maybe the holes need to be a little bit bigger, or maybe they're too big because the sockets are a little bit smaller, but you're stuck. You've already created those holes in that plywood. The other problem is the amount of time it would take to drill all of those holes. You can't do it in a drill press because typically drill presses can't reach all the way to the other side of a piece of plywood. So you end up using a drill with some drill bits, and you got to keep changing out the drill bits to get the different sized holes. It's just a lot of work and doesn't come up with a good solution. After reviewing all of those different ideas and methods for organizing sockets, I decided that I would just do something different. I cut a lot of small square dowels and glued them to a piece of plywood. If you'd like to watch the video of how I built it, you can click right here and see how I built and laid out all of the sockets. Here, let's look at the socket drawer. And this is how the drawer turned out. I have all of my impact sockets here, my half-inch drive, my 3/8 deep well sockets, and my 1/4 inch deep well sockets. 3/8 sockets are here. My spark plug sockets are here. I have hex bits, Torx bits, 12 point square bits. I have a little bin here for all of my adapters, small extensions, and wobbles. And then I have all my 1/4 inch drive sockets are over here. Right here I have a trough where I keep my torque wrench, my ratchets, and my long extensions. The great thing is if I wanted to move these sockets to right there, then I can easily just take some of these dowels and I can glue them onto the plywood. And after they dry, I can just move the sockets to this side, and using a chisel, I can remove this dowel over here. The great thing is that now I've organized my drawer, I don't have to go through these sockets. These are all duplicates, and before I organized the drawer, I'd have to pilfer through all of these sockets looking for just one size. Now, I don't have to worry about that. This method turned out really great. I've got plenty of space to add more sockets in the future, or I can move my sockets around if I find that having the sockets in a different location would be better. And they don't move around when I open and shut the drawer. Really turned out great. Well, I hope this video has been informative for you. If you have a different method of organizing sockets, or you have a favorite that I did mention, leave a comment below and tell me about it. Thanks for watching.